For centuries, mankind has never stopped looking at the sky and asking a question: is there life in another corner of the universe? With the development of technology, the search for the answer to this question has accelerated. However, concepts such as habitable zone do not always give us the hope we expect. Today, we will examine in detail the planets that stand out in the search for answers to this question and the facts about them. First, let's take a closer look at the term habitable zone. This term describes the distance around a star where liquid water can exist. However, this does not automatically mean that the planet can harbor life. Being in the habitable zone is only the first step. Kepler 22b. This massive planet is in the habitable zone, but its surface may be covered with water hundreds of kilometers deep. Such a deep ocean may not offer favorable conditions to support the chemical reactions necessary for life to begin. Moreover, the lack of energy resources dampens hopes for the suitability of this planet for life. A much more Earth-like candidate, Kepler-186f. This planet lies in the habitable zone and is likely to have a solid surface. However, problems start here too. The role of the atmosphere. If Kepler-186f has no atmosphere, its surface could be colder than Mars. On the other hand, if the atmosphere is present and creates an intense greenhouse effect, the planet could become very hot. This delicate balance is the key factor that determines whether the planet can support life. As a result, Kepler-186f could be either an ice box or an oven. These conditions would severely reduce its chances of harboring life. Now let's look a little closer. Proxima b, this planet orbits Proxima Centauri, the closest star system to us. However, you may want to restrain your hopes for this planet. Effect of red dwarfs. Proxima Centauri is a red dwarf star and constantly emits violent bursts of radiation. These explosions may have completely destroyed Proxima b's atmosphere. Gravitational lock. Proxima b is also in a gravitational lock. This means that one side of the planet is always daytime and the other side is always nighttime. As a result, it is almost impossible to achieve a balance between these conditions to support life. The TRAPPIST-1 system was once very promising. The seven planets in this system were very close in size to Earth, and three of them were in the habitable zone. James Webb's findings. Investigations by the James Webb Space Telescope showed that these planets may have lost their atmospheres. TRAPPIST-1b in particular appears to be a supermercury without an atmosphere. Other planets may have shared a similar fate. This situation has eliminated the TRAPPIST-1 system from our hopes in the search for life. In this gloomy picture, a ray of light has appeared, TOI-700d. This planet is located in the habitable zone and orbits a relatively less risky star. Atmosphere and location. TOI-700d could offer conditions similar to Earth, given the amount of energy it receives from its star. Moreover, its distance from its star increases the chances of preserving its atmosphere. This is an important advantage in terms of the presence of liquid water on the planet's surface and the formation of favorable conditions for potential life. However, our knowledge about this planet is still limited, and more research is needed to reach a definitive conclusion. TOI-700d remains one of the most promising candidates in our search for life. The search for life in space represents not only the endeavor to find other living beings in the universe, but also scientific and technological progress. By bringing together many different disciplines, this quest both expands humanity's body of knowledge and provides a foundation for future space exploration. Studying conditions on different planets can provide important clues about how life began and evolved. Understanding whether life is a phenomenon unique to Earth could lead to revolutionary discoveries in the fields of biology and astrobiology. The search for life also accelerates the development of telescope technology, sensors, and other scientific instruments. The James Webb Space Telescope and similar projects contribute not only to space exploration, but also to environmental and climate studies on Earth. Future space missions and more powerful telescopes will allow us to study in more detail the atmospheres and surface conditions of planets in habitable zones. The telescopes that will soon come online will be able to make much more precise measurements to look for signs of life in the atmospheres of planets. Detection of methane, oxygen, and other biological trace gases is critical for assessing a planet's potential to harbor life. New planets are being discovered every day. Among these discoveries, there may be planets with a high potential to harbor life, and that could upset our current theories. Every journey into the unknown in space exploration is a new ray of hope for humanity. The search for life in the deep universe is an endeavor to find answers to one of the greatest and most exciting questions in human history. Planets such as Kepler-22b, Kepler-186f, Proxima-b, TRAPPIST-1, and TOI-700d show us the diversity and complexity of the universe and are also a source of inspiration that shapes our dreams. Although some planets have been disappointing, candidates like TOI-700d keep our hopes alive. The scientific studies and technological advances made in this process contribute to our understanding of not only the search for life in space, but also the value of life on Earth. One day, when we look to the sky, we may find a sign that will prove we are not alone. But until that day, we will continue to search and learn. Because the universe is waiting for us to share the secrets it hides in its infinite darkness. For more of this kind of information, don't forget to subscribe and like our channel, and let's meet in the comments.